Join us as we try not to make the moon cry, as we review Catch the Moon from Tames and Cosmos, who we have to thank for sending us a review copy to check out.
Catch the Moon is a dexterity game by Fabian Raffaut and Juan Rodriguez. It features artwork by Emmanuel Mallon and was first published in North America by Cosmos Games back in 2017 and is still readily available.
This ladder stacking game plays 1 to 6 players, with games usually lasting well under half an hour. The rules are super simple, and the game can be enjoyed by players of pretty much any age, though you may have to worry about ladders breaking or going into the mouths of very young kids.
In Catch the Moon, players are attempting to reach the moon by building a stack of precariously balanced ladders. Each turn, a new ladder will be added to the growing stack, but if any fall, you will make the moon cry. The player who made the moon makes the moon the least sad wins. What you get with Catch the Moon is a big plastic cloud base with several holes in it to insert 2 starting ladders, a bunch of misshapen birchwood ladders, a custom D6, and 7 raindrops representing the moon's tiers. There is a felt-lined box insert to hold all of this, as well as instructions in multiple languages. Instructions are very clear and include ways to play competitively, cooperatively, and solo.
Opponent quality here is very good, though the die could use to have its features a little bit darker. The ladders are nice and light and come in a variety of different shapes, including things like missing rungs, which makes stacking them even more fun.
Now, to play Catch the Moon, you place the plastic base out on the table, stick 2 of the 3 straight-edged ladders, there's one spare in case you break one, into the holes on the base. There are multiple different configurations for this, including the ladders being able to lean various ways.
Then the first player, the last one to see a full moon, rolls the die and places a ladder using one hand only. The die features 3 different possible symbols. A single ladder, which means the newly placed ladder must touch 1 and only 1 other ladder when placed. A double ladder, which means the new ladder must touch 2 and only 2 ladders when placed. Or a moon, which means the newly placed ladder must end up being the highest point in the structure after being placed.
Now, a ladder placed on a moon can touch 1 or 2 other ladders, but no more than 2. Note this isn't as clear as it should be in the Cosmos version of the rules.
If you fail at following these rules when placing your ladder, or if any of the ladders fall, touch the table or the cloud, you made the moon cry. Take a raindrop token, and your turn ends.
Any ladders that fell, and the one being placed, if it hadn't been placed, like if you knock stuff off before you let go, they are removed from the game, as are any that are touching the base, if possible. Sometimes things fall in a way where a ladder is touching the cloud or the table and still holding things up. Those stay into play until they can be safely removed.
The game continues until you run out of tiers, or ladders, and the winner is the player with the least tiers. If 2 or more players are tied and there are ladders left, you continue to play as if each player rolled a moon on the die, with players being eliminated if they can't place a ladder. If there's a tie with no ladders left, you share the victory.
That's the basic game. Playing cooperatively has players working together to build the highest structure they can. They collect a set of tiers based on the number of players and take turns rolling the die and building the structure as normal. At any point, though, players can turn in a tier to score. This is based on how high the structure is and is actually compared to the box lid. Ladders sticking past the top of the box are worth 1 point, where ladders completely over the top of the box are worth 3. Anytime someone makes a mistake, though, one of the scoring tiers is lost, and the game is over when the group has no more tiers.
There are rules for playing solo, which are just the cooperative rules, but you just play by yourself and try to beat your own high score, which isn't much, but it works.
Now, I love dexterity games, and I adore the theme of this one, as well as the fascinating physics in play here. Catch the Moon is one of the most funky stacking games out there, and it's all due to the wonky ladders that come in this game. Their weight and their shape and the way they interlock with each other is just fun to play with. Similar to Drop It, another great dexterity game we've reviewed in the past, things don't quite act the way you'd expect at first.
You're also not able to pick which ladder you're going to place, as you're supposed to be blind reaching into the box to choose, so you may not even get a ladder with the features or shape you're hoping for to match that die roll placement. Yep.
Now, this is also probably one of the simplest games, or possibly the simplest game in my collection to teach. Roll the die and place a ladder with three possible, very easy to understand options. Touch one, touch two, or be the highest. That's it. That's combined with a cute and approachable theme that makes this game fantastic for public play events and for gamers of all ages.
Now, it remains to be seen how resilient and sturdy the pieces are. The spear starter piece doesn't actually inspire confidence, but so far we haven't actually seen any real concerns. Mishandling, of course, can be a concern for any game. So,
yeah, the ladders definitely do feel a little flimsy. I would be extremely worried if someone like bumped into the game or if it fell off the table. But as Sean mentioned, that's kind of a concern with most games. Now, one surprise to me was the fact the game included cooperative and solo play. Like, I actually wonder if this was something that was added in later printings, because I noted on Board Game Geek, it's listed as a 2-6 player game. And yes, I submitted a correction, so that could be fixed. Personally, I prefer the competitive game, but I love that there is a cooperative version, as I know many game groups that prefer to play that way. And cooperative is often better when playing with younger kids.
And the cooperative, at least when you're first learning the game and the interactions, is not easy. The box isn't large, but it seems enormous when you're trying to get ladders to reach up high enough, and you keep rolling that single ladder so that you're never really able to build a support structure for other players to place ladders onto.
Yep. Overall, Cats of the Moon is, it's exactly what it sounds like, right? There's no surprises. It's a stacking dexterity game featuring funky wooden ladders. It happens to be a game I love. My kids love it. My extended family likes it, and it was a huge hit at our last game night at the Barbershop Bar here in Windsor. Super easy to teach, accessible, and just fun.
That is, if you like dexterity games. If you don't like this style of game, or more importantly, if you have issues with shaky hands, Pitch the Moon probably isn't a good fit for you.
Yeah, this one just didn't hit for Deanna, my wife, who generally doesn't like dexterity games. This didn't win her over. It also was, there was an issue when I was at the Barbershop Bar with one gamer at our last game that actually found the game impossible to play due to slightly shaky hands. It doesn't take much to knock everything over in this game. But in general, if you like dexterity games, especially stacking ones, you should love Catch the Moon.
Well, that's all we have to say about that. Thank you for joining us for this review of Catch the Moon from Cosmos, a ladder stacking dexterity game with super simple rules. What's your favorite stacking game? Be sure to tell us about it in the comments.
Or better yet, join us on the Tabletop Bellhop Discord and let us know there. You can find it at discord.tabletopbellhop.com.